What's up, everybody? It's your host, Kurt Dragoon. And guys, in today's video, I'm combining two series that I'm making. I'm combining Cleric Dragoon attacks with Beat This Old Bass. Because as you can see, guys, this is an older meta bass. It's obvious, it's tight, it's compact, it's symmetrical. It all spells old meta. So guys, with this particular attack, this bass, to me, it does scream two different attacks. It screams Sacrificial Royal Mass Hog, or it screams Sacrificial Royal Laloon, or Sui Lalo. And so for me, I'm an air guy. I like air. Even though I do ground attacks, guys, I love air attacks. So I decided, hey, let's go air. So right here, guys, what I'm going to do, oops, sorry about that. That's the next bass you'll see. I'm going to go in and start telling you how I'm going to take this bass. So, what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to throw a wizard here and a wizard here. And they're just going to eliminate these structures, right? Because what I'm trying to do is with this Sui Lalo, and I'm going to stick a baby drag here. Because he'll eliminate all of this. And he'll cut off this area. But what I'm trying to do, guys, I am trying to funnel my heroes into this channel. To this AD and get the queen. Grab the CC. I mean, it's all about, you know, taking out what you got to take out in most of your attacks. So let me just erase this. So what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to stick my royals in, king and queen, right about here. They're going to start eliminating these things here. You know, queen will hit this. You know, queen will start in here. King, you know, he's going to do his thing. He's going to eliminate the queen. And they're going to basically walk in, just like I wanted, into this channel, and the bass is made that way. It's made to perfectly channel, you know, the into that area. So the CC is going to be pulled. I'm going to poison at some point. We'll do this. There'll be a poison around in here somewhere. Could be farther back. I don't know, but it's going to be right there. And then while that's going on, after the CC kill, I'm going to drop a skelly right here on this air defense. And it's gonna take out some of the neighboring defenses, you know, the fire off the queen. I want the queen to get into that channel and get that AD down. And the skelly spell, you know, being that the space is so tight, I could waste a spell on that, and I did. So that's what I did, guys. And so that's my plan for the CC queen and AD kill. Now I've got three air defense left, and I could have went two hounds and got three ADs, but I decided to go three. Because it was a really tight base. There's gonna be a lot of DPS on the hounds. And so I went three, and that may have been a mistake, but that's the way I went. So what we're gonna do here, guys, my first hound's gonna come across right here. Second hound is gonna come across right here. And the third hound is gonna come across right here. And basically this Lalo is gonna push through that base. And I know a lot of people saying, Dragoon, why did you choose Lalo? Well, I'm going to show you something, guys, about this base. And it's a perfect hog base. Yes, it is. But look at the ADs. Look at the air sweepers. Look how far out of position they are. They're not protecting anything. So I knew that my Laloon would move through the space very quickly and destroy the space. So I'm going to come in with my balloons now. And I'm going to put several balloons here, probably five or six. I'll just put five. Then I'm going to come in here. I'm going to come in heavy with a set, probably another five balloons here. And I'm just going to try to sprinkle these balloons in, you know, because I've got 28 balloons in this attack. But basically, I'm going to save a few after I drop some on this last position here. I'm going to save a few balloons for the back end, you know, just for cleanup. You know, just to make sure everything works out. And so, guys, I literally use no spells as far as rage or anything like that on the front end of this attack. So I've got a ton of spells, and so I'm gonna do a nice little rage right there, and then I'm probably gonna use some haste spells, and I'm gonna haste, you know, around in here. Probably gonna haste into that. You know, haste here, you know, that's the plan. Just haste everything in, you know, and then I'm gonna watch. And the thing is, at this point, You know, I've got another rage to use, and I may use it here. You know, it just depends on how everything's going. I'm just gonna watch everything, and at that point, I've got another spell, but we'll have to see. Well, actually, no, that's all the spells. That's it, guys. So I got two rages, three haste, and then I got four haste. Maybe I got four haste because I got a poison, a skelly. Yeah, I think I got another haste. So I'll have a haste, and that last spell could either be a haste. Like, it just depends on what I need done on this section of the base. So if I can get away with the haste, I'll swag the rage. I mean, that's what's gonna happen. But you know, if I need it, like, you gotta watch how everything pans out. And really and truly, when I plan these Laloons, there's you know, a certain amount of feel for the attack for me. I just watch my balloons, I see how they're flying, I see how much damage you're taking, and I rage or haste accordingly. And there's some of that I can't be rigid on my attack. I have to be ready to respond to what's happening in the attack, and you have to kind of be fluid. Does that mess you up at times? Do you make the wrong move sometimes? Absolutely, it does happen. But guys, I assure you, in this attack, it does not. So we're going to go ahead and take a look at the actual attack, and here we go. All right, guys, so here's the actual attack. And guys, I elected to use a couple of giants to tank my royals a little bit, give them a little extra time to get into the pocket. And so that's what I did. And I've actually deployed my wizards a little bit after my king and queen, hoping that the king and queen would maybe, and the giants would take some fire. So I did change my plan just a little bit, guys, and those giants really didn't give me a whole lot of value, to be honest. That the DPS on an old meta base is really high. It's very dense with defenses, and man, it is rough. It is rough. So as you can see here, that Skelly is taking the Archer Tower. Well, actually, the Archer Tower is targeting the Queen still. So it did not work. I was kind of hoping that it would take some of that off, but look, guys, my Lalo's already proceeding. I seen the AD was going to go down. And as you can see here, I didn't use that rage where I thought I was. I ended up not using it there. So I'm down to there. Well, I did use it. Yep. I thought I did. So I did. I used the rage there. And I ended up, instead of using that rage on the next bow, guys, I ended up using a haste. Because I was looking at my hounds, and I literally had a hound up. And if you've got a hound up, there's no need to push your balloons forward. You just let them move through the base. Don't worry about it. The hound's still tanking them. Of course, I say that an Archer Tower was targeting my balloon. So dirty. But anyway, everything was cool. So, you know, I decided not to rage. There was no need. That was overkill. And I was kind of hoping for that hound to pop. But as you guys can see, I've got a ton of cleanup. I'm going to swag that rage in the center, and I'm going to call it a day for this old base. All right, guys, this next hit was a cleanup attack for me. And this base was hit by Draven, and he rolls a slap on this base, or a Gobo Wee Wee. I'm sorry, a Gobo Wee Wee. And it's not successful. I'm just going to speed through it because these planning videos do take a little bit of time. Just going to let you know, I see all the Tesla positions. That's the one good thing about a Gobo Wee Wee or a Witch Slap, is they do expose all of the Teslas. But Draven just comes up short on this attack, and you know, he fails. Okay, guys, as you guys seen, this particular attack on this old meta base was a cleanup attack. So I had full knowledge of pretty much all the traps that were ground related, being that it was hit with a Witch Slap. So I'm going to tell you, you know, I knew where the Tesla positions were. You know, they were down here. I think there might be one either here or here. I'm trying to remember, but that's okay. No big deal. That's just part of the attack. So what I'm going to do here, guys, I looked at this particular base, and the first thing, you know, when we're scouting a base, this is the first thing you got to do. You look, depending on the type of method you want to scout, you know, that you're comfortable with. Your comfort zone of attacks is you're looking for me, I'm looking for sweeper positions, and let me get a different color. Let's get one that's pretty bright. We're looking for sweeper positions. I'm looking for air defense. I'm looking for queen and CC. That's what I'm looking at. And so for me, this base was screaming, go Bola Loon. The sweepers are not really effective. You know, I seen the Tesla positions. Like I said, I didn't see the black air mines or the red air mines or whatever. I don't know where they are. But as far as the air defense positions, the bows, guys, by the way, the bows are on ground. They are on ground. Let me undo that so you can see it. So I was just like, oh, this is a no-brainer. So right here, I'm going to stick a golem. He's going to be right there. And I'm going to stick a golem right here. And I'm going to come in with some whiz. I think I got about 8 whiz. I'm going to come in like this. You know, stick some wizards here. Shower in some wizards here. I might even put 3 whiz here. And then, so I'm just going to wait for a second, guys. You let your funnel form. Let the wizards cut the funnel. Then I'm going to do a test wall breaker right here. And then I'm going to do the other 3. You want to make sure you don't hit an outside bomb. And I don't think I talk about those things most of the time in my attack planning. I just assume everybody, you know, knows that. And maybe you do, maybe you don't. But I'm just going to include these tidbits. So basically at that point, I'm going to drop my royals. And my royals are coming in. Then I'm going to drop my CC bowlers. And they're coming in. There's a nice big hole there. I'm going to drop a jump right here, which is going to get me into basically three compartments. This one, this one, and this one. So that's super value for that jump. Then as everything's working in, I'm going to try to get this rage as deep set as possible. And I've got a rage and a heal for my kill squad, because guess what, guys? Once the kill squad gets in this box, you know, they could pretty much take out 3 air defense if possible. So you want to sustain your push into this base. So once everything's going, you know, I'm going to start my Lalo. And so I'm basically counting on, you know, getting one of these ADs down. And of course the one that the kill squad's jumping over. But once 2 go down, I'm going to start my Lalo. And guys, the base is symmetrical. So my plan, I could start the Lalo, you know, from any side, but preferably I wanted to start it from this side. So that's what I'm going to do, guys. I'm going to wait for that AD. Hopefully it goes down. And once it does, I'm going to start my Laloon. And so what we're going to do, I'm going to come across here with the first town. And guys, this is a gobo, a shattered. So I only have 2 hounds. So I got to make this work. And I only got about, I think, 12 balloons. So I'm going to come in here with about 4. I'm going to come in here with 1 because it's a cannon. Then I'm going to drop some here, maybe 3. And there's Teslas here. Don't forget, there's Teslas right there. So I'm going to drop some more balloons here. And I think I drop a pretty heavy amount, another 3 right here. So, and as it's working out, you know, you can see already I'm getting close to my capacity here. So then I'm just basically, I'm gonna drop pretty much all balloons but 1. I think I'm gonna drop another couple of balloons here, and then I'm just gonna save 1 balloon. And so I'm gonna push these balloons with haste, and I'm gonna push them through basically around here and around here and then around here. That's my plan. I'm trying to push, as you can see, that half circle motion through the base, trying to push those balloons through the base. And that's what I want to do. That's my plan. Let's see how it actually turned out. All right, guys, we've seen the plan. Now here's the actual attack. And by the way, Pappy is one of my Town Hall 9 accounts. And here we go. You can see my wizards down, waiting on the funnel on both sides. Got the more wizards down here. Got 3 and 3 right now. making the funnel. Just be patient. I dropped a test wall breaker. I dropped three wall breakers behind, and now I'm going in. So right now I'm happy. Life's good. There's the jump. The rage is coming very soon, and I seen a lava hound. I was not happy about a lava hound. I'm going to tell you, a lava hound on this particular attack will slow it down. But I knew there was a hound in the CC because of the particular first attack by Draven. And so, I was just going to have to deal with it. So there you go. Hounds pop. I've used my rage, my heal, the poison. And guess what, guys? It's time to lie low. So here comes my loons. Here comes my second hound. More balloons. And at this point, here comes the haste. And everything's just working through. And right here, I'm watching my hounds. I'm like, okay, are we gonna pop here? Do I need to use this haste? And right now, I've decided no. My hounds, I think both of my hounds have popped though. But I started thinking swag. But then I was like, well, do I just need to move through this? I'm just gonna move through it. You know, I did think of swag. I had visions of swag in my head, but ultimately I thought about time. I was like, let's just kind of try to get this base down in a fast amount of time. So that's it, guys. I went ahead and used it. It's ripped the dream for this old base. And guys, I hope you enjoyed this. I really like both series. I like the ones where, you know, I'm doing my attack planning because I know I thought my thought process through the whole thing. And of course, I like this old base because there's a lot of you guys out there facing those style of bases, and I know that content is pertinent to you. So guys, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Let me know what you think in the comments, guys. And with that being said, thank you for all your support and all that you do. And guys, I am out of here.